All right, guys, we wanted to welcome you all to this awesome, this is our, we do a once a month team-wide meeting, and we actually usually do it the second Monday of the month, but we had that BOGO going on last night, so we decided, you know what, we got to work the BOGO all the way till midnight, so we decided to go ahead and switch our team meeting to today. So we are just, or tonight, I should say. So we are just so excited, guys. We have about, I don't know, 12 people that are going to share about a minute of their best tips. These are people who just promoted to executive, ruby, emerald, diamond, double diamond last month. So we're going to have people share tips first, the first part of the call, because I want you guys to all hear what it looks like when you decide in your head that you're going to be going for a promotion. It's not something that happens by accident ever. Promotions are always done intentionally. So I want people to share, as we call people out here, they'll share who they are, where they're from, how long they've been in this business, if they want to share a quick why they joined this business, and then their best business building tips, one or two of them, from the month of March. How in the world you got to where you got, okay? So we're going to start with, am I yelling at you guys? Does it sound like I'm yelling? No, they don't see. John says I'm being loud, and I'm like, I don't think I'm yelling.
Sounds loud.
By the way, for you, those of you that are new, we are John and Liz Enter from Nicollet, Minnesota.
And we typically dispute over Zoom.
Yeah, and we have been in this business almost 4 years. Well, it's not even close. October will be 4 years. And we have been able to be full-time parents with It Works Global. This business has allowed us to John to retire or rewire from his construction business, and we do this as a full-time business partners, and we have three kiddos. I used to be a past Lutheran school teacher and wanted to be a stay-at-home mom and raise my own kiddos, and so this is the dream, guys. If you want to change your world with this type of a business, this industry, this type of company, you can totally do this. It's going to take some hard work. It's going to take some focus. It's going to take some intentional action, but you can totally make this happen. So we are going to get started and let you guys hear from some people who are actually putting their talk to making it into their walk, right? Making their, what's the word?
Their talk, their walk.
Yeah, their talk, their walk. All right, so here we go. First person is Kelsey Brandt on? Raise your hand if you're on, Kelsey. Unmute yourself if you are on. If you're on by phone, maybe. See, there's two pages, baby. See, let me see.
Now there is.
Let me see. Where is Kelsey? Does anybody see Kelsey? I don't see Kelsey. Okay, so then while we're waiting for her, Alyssa Anlin, where are you?
Yeah.
Is Kelsey here? Okay, so go ahead, Alyssa Anlin, go ahead and unmute yourself. And I want you to share, Kelsey.
Well, I'm trying to find who she is, where she is.
Your talk, so who cares?
Just a second here. Kayla, why don't you mute yourself, honey, if you don't mind. Bottom left screen. Do you see that? Okay, there you go. So Alyssa?
Yes, ma'am.
All right, so go ahead. There we go. I want you to share, you just popped diamond and got a $20,000 get out of debt bonus from our company. So go ahead and share a little about who you are, where you're from, a little of your why, and then a business building tip or two from how you promoted in March.
So I am Alyssa Anlin. I am from Howard Lake, Minnesota. I have been in this business since October of 2014. I joined first as a loyal customer to try the products. I needed to get my health into better shape. I have a medical condition and I just needed to take care of me. And I booked a party for my upline, you know, to support her business at the time without any intention of joining the business. But I had a really good party. So I had like 9 guests that were there, and you know, I had 5 people that signed up as loyal customers, and my upline said, "Do you realize that instead of my loyal customers, these could be yours?" And I kind of sat on it for about 3 days, and it was enough for me to say, "All right, well, I guess I'm going to jump in." And you know, it's, I wouldn't say I hit the ground running, but I jumped in and, you know, because I wanted to share the products with everyone. They were helping me, so I wanted to help everyone else with it. So a very slow process for me. I didn't start sharing the business until a few months after I'd already been in. And even that, like, it was a really timid thing for me to do. So it's taken this time for me to gain more confidence and be where I feel more comfortable with it, because now I've seen the potential and what it can do. And I definitely heard the stories and I have seen other people do it, but it's definitely helped over the time for me to experience it. You know, with, I've got a fast growing team and I've got a lot of people on my team that are super strong, and they've definitely pushed me and actually taught me so much for their mm-hmm. actions and what they do that I couldn't be more grateful for that. So, you know, and as far as like getting to the promotion, you know, I double promoted, I went Emerald and Diamond, and I couldn't have done it without my team. We worked very close together. We really did everything that we needed to do together. And, you know, I've got strong leaders on my team, and that is what, you know, it takes to succeed. But I would strongly suggest being consistent. You know, if I had to give a tip, it would be being consistent and following up, you know, whether, you know, and if you work full time, I work part time every day, but schedule it in. You know, if you can schedule a half hour, an hour, if you can do a power hour every day where you can get rid of all distractions, you can fit it in and you can be effective if you work that hour like you need to. That would be my advice.
Awesome. Congratulations, Miss Alyssa. We are so proud of you. Seriously, so awesome. All right, we're going to keep moving because we have several to get through. Is Kelsey Brandt on now? Did you see Kelsey on at all, Alyssa? Yep. Okay, Kelsey, can you unmute yourself? I got to find you. Kelsey, do you know how to unmute yourself? Bottom left?
Back to the large screen.
Nope.
There you go. You got it. You got it. wave your hand. All right. Share with everybody who you are, where you're from, and a little bit of your why, and then quickly a couple business building tips that you really did in this month to make, or this past month, to make sure that you hit Ruby.
Yep.
Right, Ruby. Okay, go ahead.
I'm from Belle Plaine, Minnesota. I went Ruby, and my why is to help my dad, because he's helped me and my sister out with so much that I want to turn around and do a favor and give him the life that he should have. And then my quick tip is I work full-time. So for me, it was actually just making, or having my upline make me sit down and actually do a power hour. Getting together and just the motivation from it really helped, really lit that fire, got me going.
That's awesome. So do you want to keep that momentum flowing into this month too, Kelsey? Or are you feeling like you just want to stick to Ruby?
Oh, no. I want to keep going. I want to get Diamond by the end of this month.
Awesome. Isn't it that sweet taste when you think that you can't and then you do get it? It's amazing how it's like, oh, baby, nothing's holding me back now. The confidence goes through the roof, doesn't it?
Yep.
I'm so stinking proud of you. Seriously.
Thank you.
Awesome job. All right, let's move on. And if you can mute yourself out, that'd be awesome just to keep the recording really clean. Let's move on to Stacey During. Stacey During's also a diamond $20,000 good bonus earner.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Stace.
So I'm Stacey During from Mankato, Minnesota. And the end of this month, I will be with It Works for 2 years. And my initial why was I was a loyal customer for a year and absolutely loved the products. And so I knew coming in that I could, use the products and find a couple other people that would also, enjoy the product. So I just basically came in to cover the cost of my product. And that was my initial reasoning for flipping over from a loyal customer to a distributor. And as far as tips for how, you know, for how to have a strong month or I don't know what I'm trying to say right now, but I would say the biggest thing is if you do have team members to plug in with those team members and work together, because it truly is better together. And again, I work full time as well. I'm very busy with my kids, so the power hour, like they said. But the big thing about the power hour is to not use a power hour of just surfing Facebook. To actually utilize a power hour, and that means reaching out to numbers of people. One thing like at the It Works You that we were just at in Michigan, Joel Dunn said one thing about numbers, you know, of how if you want to be a millionaire, you know, how do you have to do that? And it was the guy responded back and said, you have to reach out to 3,000 people and ask 3,000 people. And of those 300 people that will maybe ask for information from you, and of those 300 people, maybe 30 of those people will be interested. And of those 30 people, only 3 will sign, but those 3 will be the ones that bring you to millionaire. So you think about that, of if you're reaching out to people, don't be reaching out to the same 5 people. You know, you might have it in your head that those 5 are going to be your runners with you, but it might not be the right timing for them. So don't focus in on just those same people. Keep moving on and come back to them. But you got to reach out to those 3,000 to find your 3. So that would be my tip.
I love that.
I love that.
I love that, Stacy. And, you know, I just pulled out the calculator and did the math on that, because we all know that when we put our, when we figure our goals, like Joel says, he's a green personality. He figures his goals down to the letter. And when you take 3,000 people, depending on how fast you want to go, if you take 3,000 people on 365 days, that only comes to 8.2 people per day. That's it. I mean, does that sound doable or not? Like, if you were to reach out to 8 people a day,
7 days a week,
7 days a week for a whole year in order to find 3 people that would help you become a millionaire, that seems totally doable.
And that's honestly like what our team, we were shooting for like 10 to 15 people a day. We had some reaching out to 20 people a day. And if they ran out of people on their hundreds list, they were going to find more people. Meeting new people or blitzing new people. I mean, that's truly, you got to move outside of your comfort zone if you want to move. So it's just about connecting with the people and reaching out to as many people of what you can.
And then I see your counterpart sitting next to you.
Yeah.
I think it's just a matter of holding each other accountable, right?
Right.
I mean, if you say that you want to reach out to 8 people per day, and your counterpart sits next to you and says, hey, did you get your 8 today? And you do that every day for a whole year. I mean, that's really the other part of the equation, I think.
Exactly. Well, and that's the thing. I mean, yes, we promoted last month, but we're doing another power hour tonight. You know, so it just doesn't stop there. It's of sitting down, mapping it out, having a game plan, and really diving into your team of how that game plan can be done, you know? So you can't just sit back and hope for it. You got to kind of, you know, have a game plan behind it.
And why they call it networking, not net wishing, right?
Right, yeah. But anybody honestly can do it. I mean, it. Like I said, I've been in it for 2 years. So it doesn't happen overnight. And I've had, you know, customers quit on me. I've had distributors quit on me, and that's just all part of the growth through it. So take that as, you know, a way for you to grow and build yourself stronger, because you're going to have that. Even for the people that are just coming on that are brand new on this call, you're going to have that. So don't let that discourage you. That just means it wasn't for them, and that's okay. You know, and it doesn't mean that a year from now, they might be coming back and saying, okay, now I'm ready. Cause I've also had that happen on my team, and so blessed that gal did come back and now ready to give it a second shot. So, you know, things happen in life. Don't let that distract you and don't let that pull you down. You know, just keep your why in front of you, whatever that is. The reason that you joined, keep that in front of you and keep fighting for that.
I love it. Awesome. That was awesome. So why don't we go over to Sarah Stoddard quickly, Sarah? And I know your next goal here is to go diamond. Now, I know you were on a Zoom last night with Kim Haber, our presidential, and she had mentioned to you, are you going to diamond this month? And you kind of thought, well, I'm kind of tired from what we just did last month. But what is your shift now? You kind of changed your mindset.
She gave me a good piece of advice, and I had told her that I felt that my warm market, or the people that I reached out to, my hundreds list was pretty much used up. I reached out to a ton of people last month. That's kind of where I hit a roadblock. I was like, I don't have anyone else now. I don't want to keep reaching out to the same people. And so her advice was to, you know, look to my team, and, you know, we added new people, so their hundreds list isn't used up. So help them and, you know, get them to where they want to be. And when I help them, I'll get to where I want to be. So that's what my focus is now.
I love that. And I want to tell everybody too, I love that. I want to tell you that even if you're not up for promotion, who on your team is? Who on your team is close? Do you have some executives that are close to getting to four? You know, they need maybe just a little bit of volume. Well, then help place those loyal customers to help them win. Because when they win, you win. Who's close to Ruby? So even though you may not be there, turn your eyes down to them and figure out where they need to go to help them win as well. Because you'll get to where you need to go. You know, so that's something that I've always reminded myself of. And there's nothing more exciting than watching your team underneath you win. It's so fun. Reading all this stuff is so funny. Okay, that's awesome, girls. I love it. Congratulations.
Thanks.
All right. How about let's go right over to Miss Crystal Norell. Boom, boom. Miss,
hi.
Let me see. What did you go this last month?
I went Ruby.
You went Ruby. So tell everybody all about who you are, where you're from, and then your a little bit of your why. And then, you know, what was your mind switch? Because you've been with us for a while, too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm Crystal Norell. I'm from Nicollet. I'm John and Liz's neighbors. I've been in Works for about a year, and even though being neighbors, I never heard of it Works before I signed up under Miss Sarah Stoddard. So initially I signed up, and it was through the $1,000 bonus last year. So that was kind of what brought me on, is trying to get that bonus last year. But kind of once I learned a little bit more about the company, definitely my why kind of changed to, you know, seeing the potential for, you know, not only financial freedom, but freedom of time, is kind of my biggie right now, is because I have a really busy job and I work long hours. And so that's kind of my why now. So I have time to spend with my family and my almost 2-year-old son. But yeah, just kind of piggybacking off of Sarah and Stacy and all the other good tips. but I think, yeah, the last couple months, what really changed is, you know, I had my team, but and we worked together really good, but I think we just really came together the last couple months. And I kind of realized, like, yeah, don't have to do so. I knew that I could. Did I freeze?
I think you're doing okay now. You were frozen.
I knew that I could be with my team, and we worked together better, and kind of fed up.
I love that, Crystal. Even though you're kind of going in and out, I think I got the gist of what you said. Your team really came together more than ever at this time. And so I can't express enough. The communication should be insane crazy between your team if you're promoting. Like, you guys should be in a thread, those that are in promotional positions for you as you're going to your next levels. And there should be literally communication every single day on, hey, this is what I'm doing. What you guys doing today? You know, this is my goal plan. What is your goal plan? You know what I mean? That's how it should be. Hey, I got a distributor. I got a little customer. Little customer, you know, we need a spot here filled in. We need a spot there filled in. So it's total working together. And that's the only way these promotions work. Were you gonna say something?
Well, it just reminded me of a year ago. And I think it was about a year ago. We were down in Florida, and we were on the island, and we had run into a person who had just recently gone ambassador. And I wanted to take a moment and ask her, you know, if she could give me a tip. And she said, you know, what changed for them was, she said, we decided. And it was really funny because she had four girls with her, and they were her leaders that were with her. It was her presidential. It was her triple diamond. It was her double diamonds that were with her. And you could just see the fire in their eyes together, and that they said it together. We decided. And that told me a multitude of things. It said that they were in communication. They were on the same wavelength. They had each other's back. They were hanging out together. You know, they were having fun. You know, the relationships that we talk about, like this last weekend, all the relationships that we built by getting to know each other. So I love that. Thanks for sharing.
Yes. Congratulations, Miss Crystal. All right. So let's look at for Katie. Is Katie Risto on? Let's find her. Where's our Miss Katie? Keep going.
You want to drive, babe?
Where are you, Katie? Are you on? Look at all these pretty faces. Do you guys see her?
It'd be easier if I went.
Here, somebody, this. Like, is she on, Crystal? Yes, no? Anybody know? Stacy, do you guys know? Is she on? What's that?
I think she said she's calling from her phone when she got a chance, but I don't see her face.
If you're on, unmute yourself.
Here. I'll try and unmute this one. This is a phone number, and we'll see if that's her.
Say hello, 507-381 number. Yeah, this is what you'll have to unmute yourself. Let's just keep going and then unmute yourself here, and then we'll get you on if you're on. Okay, so how about Colleen? Is Colleen there? Hey.
Oh, me. So many people. This is so exciting.
I know. Can you turn your volume up?
I can get closer.
Here we go.
There you go.
Awesome.
All right, Miss Colleen. Okay. I still don't see you. John, maybe the next page.
Let's do this.
Speaker view. Here we go. All right, Colleen. Oh, and there's Joe. Hey, Joe.
What up, Joe?
All right, tell everybody who you are, where you're from, a little bit of your why, and your best business building tips that you absolutely smashed in the month of March.
Awesome. I am Colleen Beatty. We are from Eagle Lake, Minnesota, just a little town outside of Mankato. This month we promoted to Ruby, and it was a busy, crazy month, and it couldn't have gone better. I started this month as a year and a half ago that I started with It Works. I was a loyal customer for 2 months, and then in November I started as a distributor. And when I started it, I had several different whys for myself, versus, you know, debt-free, and different, you know, things like that. And now today my why has completely changed, and it's changed several times over the year and a half, and it's been just a fantastic run. This past month, last month again, we, like Stacy and Sarah and Crystal, all said teamwork makes the dream work. And I always think of that. Connect with your team, connect with your sidelines, connect with all of them, get your little group chats going, build each other up. My big thing this past month is I sat down and I made that power hour every single day. Whether it was 30 minutes here and 30 minutes here, I made sure it was a full, complete hour every day. I sat down and I reached out to new people. Sometimes it was the same people who were like, whoa, when a sale comes on, the book comes back, let them know. Otherwise, it was always, I try to get new people all the time. When I feel like my hundreds list was worn out, I went to my kids' Facebook, and I went and talked to their friends' parents. And then I would go to Joe's Facebook, and I started talking to all of his friends. And adding people who I didn't even know. You know, if we had five or more friends on Facebook, I would add them. And so, like that reaching out to people, talking to people, thanking them for adding you on Facebook, and then somehow adding the business into that as well. Or blitzing. Everybody's afraid of blitz. I sweat every time and my voice gets super shaky and I want to start crying sometimes when I blitz people, but I do it every single time I leave the house. I say, today I'm going to blitz somebody, and it doesn't matter where I'm at. I've got out of the car and blitzed the mom, the van next to me as I'm picking the kids up from school, and all that, you know. And like I said, you feel like you're going to throw up, but you have to do it.
I love it. Joe, what do you think about all this?
Take a brown bag along, Joe. Help her out.
What do you think about all this, Joe?
It works.
Excited. So, Colleen, are you working on the next promotion to Emerald?
We're hoping just to totally skip it and go right to Diamond.
Boom, boom. Yeah. Awesome. There you go.
Joe and I have been working hard together every single night. If he's not home in time, I start my own power hour, and he does it at his own job. He's bringing on loyal customers of his own to add. And 6 weeks? 6 weeks sober of soda and pop.
That's awesome.
Excuse me. And it's all been greens and energy. So that's I told awesome. Him about Lucy Polbert and her Papa Fun and Fiasco. And
I love it.
I've been seeing Joe drinking his greens on his posts.
Yeah, I love it. How the man's supporting, that's awesome. There's so many ways that you can totally help your woman out if you have a supporter, and bring loyal customers and drink energy and drink greens at work and have some coupons. The Blitz cards for you, those of you that are new, those are the coupon cards. I don't have one right in front of me, but you have them in your business builder kit that's coming, and definitely, you know, but don't feel like you got to have the card either. You can simply, I add people on Facebook, just connect with them there,
yep.
Ask them if they'll be my friend right there, and then continue to build the relationship with them from there. So I love it, Colleen. I love how you said you're not stopping and you're not saying I'm exhausted, I'm just going to stop, because we know that if we stop, everything will dwindle. And then all of a sudden, the awesome promotion you work so hard for, you can actually start losing it. So that's not what we want. We always teach people, once you hit the promotion, now work towards that next promotion so that you always can maintain what you just hit. So awesome job, guys. Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right. Let's go over to, let's see, how about Brittany? Is Brittany Strike, Brittany Long on? Here she is.
Hi.
Hey, girl. Tell everybody who you are, where you're from, a little bit of your why, and then your best business building tips from March.
I'm Brittany Long. I am from Howard Lake, Minnesota, and I joined, I just celebrated my year anniversary on the 25th of March. So I've been in for a little over a year now. And I joined because I lost my job when I was 8 months pregnant. And I really couldn't go out and get a job because I was about to be on maternity leave. So I kind of just signed up with this on a whim. I joined Steph's team. I really didn't think that it was going to become what it has. I honestly just thought, okay, I would do it for a little bit to get a little income and then, you know, find a job. And within my first 3 months, the promotions were coming in and our team was just getting crazy. So we just decided to stick with it. And what else did you want to know?
Well, what did you hit? Tell everybody what promotions you've hit and how many bonuses you've earned.
Well, in my first 4 weeks, I went Ruby and I got the $1,000 bonus. And then in February, I got the Diamond $20,000 good bonus. And then last month, February, I got the, March, I got the Double Diamond $30,000 bonus. So a little over $50,000 this year in bonuses. So it's been nice.
That is so awesome. And what would you say if you were going to tell those new, brand new people literally that just signed up today that are on this Zoom, and then we've got people all the way that have been in here for a while. So what would be your best business building tip if people are really wanting to go after these awesome bonuses that are here? They're not the double this month, but at least the single are there. That is so awesome. So what would you tell them, you know, if you were going to give them two tips, what would you say to go after these?
Well, all of my new distributors that I get to sign, I always tell them, you know, I always go through the easy with them, but my main thing to get them is to learn the products. I always tell my distributors, right away is to learn the products, and then that way when they know what they have in their hands, they know who they can help with the products. So that's one of my biggest things when it comes to my new distributors. But what honestly, what I learned this last month in March, I cannot stress enough consistency and follow-up. I mean, I signed, I think, like 7 or 8 distributors last month, and it was they, every single one of them were 3-plus months in the making that I've been working on. No one was, you know, just a random talk to me. I mean, I talked to all of them for months and months. So being consistent with them, always getting them on online parties or following up with them or just saying hi, you know, a day without even talking about it works to make it, you know, more of a friendship is huge, I think. So definitely being consistent is key, I would feel.
Awesome. I love that. And I'm hearing a lot of consistency, follow-up, a lot of power hours, a lot of, you know, planting of lots of seeds. And, you know, nobody should think of this as an overnight get-rich scheme. It really isn't. It's going to be where you plant a ton of seeds everywhere, whether that's handing out coupons or messaging people. You know, Brittany, do you do a lot of Instagram or do you do Facebook, or what is your primary way of reaching out to people?
You know, I do a little bit of everything. I kind of go in spurts. I've always... you know what, I've done both. I get a lot of success off Instagram, and then that goes cold. I get a lot of success on Facebook. I promote them both the same times. Like, I'll always promote something on each, but the success on both of them kind of goes in spurts. When I do Instagram, it's definitely more cold messaging and direct messaging there, whereas Facebook is more advertising and marketing, I would say, but both have been very successful, that's for sure.
Awesome. And what would you say with this last month that you've really been promoting, what would you say has been your investment of time that has been required to hit your goals?
I'm not going to lie. I worked a lot. I was on my phone a lot. I definitely went through a lot of phone batteries, but I truly just felt that I'm going to get out of this what I put in it. So, I mean, I couldn't even put a time to it. I definitely work 7 days a week. But I also like jumped on every single opportunity that I could. Like if somebody was messaging, hey, I'm home, I was like, hey, can we Zoom quick for me to go over this? Like I always get people on the phone or I go meet up with them. It's been 8, 9 o'clock at night and someone says we're just getting home. I'm like, okay, well, I'm coming over. Oh, I gotta leave. Thank God for my husband to stay with the girls and know that I had to get the, you know, I was going for bonus time. But yeah, it was definitely a lot of time that we put into this and it paid off.
That's awesome. I love it. Thank you so much, Brittany. We are so proud of you. Congratulations, girl.
Thank you so much.
Yes. All right, let's go over to Miss Becky Fenstermaker. Where are you? This is so good. I hope you guys are writing down notes. I'm like going nuts writing down all these notes. Becky's hey. Right here. I can see her. There we go. Hey, girl.
Hey.
All right. Share with everybody who you are, where you're from, why you joined, and then a top business building tip from March.
Okay. So I am Becky Fenstermaker. I'm in Columbus, Ohio. I joined for a couple of reasons. I've always struggled with my weight most of my life. In high school, I actually had a bout with Steph.
That chat is so distracting.
When I was in high school, I actually had a bout with anorexia and bulimia. So as I got older, I felt like, you know, when I became a mom, my kids were number one. And I always felt that that meant that I had to put myself on the back burner. And when I got on the scale on Thanksgiving this past year, I saw that I was at 242 and I just lost it. Because even though my body was bigger, my confidence was gone. And sorry.
Now I gotta go get some Kleenexes.
I just realized that something needed to change and that something just clicked in me that it was time to start taking care of me. you know, that I wasn't, it's not that I wasn't going to continue to take care of my kids, but I had to learn that if I wasn't happy, my kids weren't happy. And I was not in a good place. So I joined on January 3rd because I wanted to get healthy and lose weight so I could be a wonderful role model to my kids. And, you know, the products, I fell in love with them immediately. I didn't start as a loyal customer. I just jumped in. I ordered my business builder kit like everybody else. I ordered greens, ThermoFit, and Fat Fighters, started on them immediately. I'm now down 38 pounds. I feel amazing. I feel better than I've probably felt since I was a teenager. And my confidence is back. I've, you know, this company, you know, the constant encouragement from our upline, from, you know, Liz and John, I mean, I can't express my gratitude enough. Such a huge blessing. Everybody on this team has been such a huge blessing to me. You know, people tell me all the time I'm a motivation for them and I'm inspiring, but it's really all of you guys that are an inspiration to me that keeps me going. And so this last month, you know, I just joined on January 3rd. And so for the last month, it was, you know, since I'm still a newbie, it wasn't really, what am I going to do to be different? It was just, I knew that I had to give it 110% because I need this. You know, my family needs this. I need this. And I found my faith again. And, you know, the biggest tips that I can give are, you know, three things that I make sure that I do every day is, you know, I'm praying and spending time in my word and in devotionals. I'm personally developing every single day, finding who I am again, finding my confidence and finding out that I'm not perfect and it's okay. But the biggest thing I can say is consistency. And I haven't slept much. I have a full-time job. I do in daycare with kids. And then as soon as my daycare kids leave, I'm working my It Works business full-time, at least 6 to 7 hours every night. You know, and I sacrifice sleep. I have nonstop for the last 3.5 months. And, you know, I'll sleep when I'm dead, you know. I'm trying to build my I'm trying to build my legacy here, you know. I want to promote. So I promoted to Ruby, and I grabbed the $1,000 bonus, which that in turn finally made my husband a believer that I could do this and that this was not a network marketing scheme. It wasn't a pyramid scheme. And business has just been wonderful. I have had times where I was discouraged because I felt like there were days where I wasn't bringing on loyal customers. I wasn't bringing on distributors. What am I doing wrong? And that's why I say my biggest tip is consistency. You know, we have to plant the seeds. You have to take the time to form relationships. It's not just selling a product. You're selling yourself. People want to see that you're having success with this business and with the products. And if you're a product of the product, the stuff sells itself. So you get out what you put in.
I love
That's
it.
That's awesome.
And what is your goal by month end, Becky?
Diamond, duh. My nickname is Bling Bling Becky. I have to go diamond.
Awesome. I love your heart. It's so beautiful. And you made me cry.
Tell your husband to let you back inside now.
Yeah, you're in the garage. It looks like you're kicked out.
It's the only place I knew I could have a steady signal.
Awesome.
Thanks
Thank
for sharing.
Thank you. Congratulations.
It was great hanging out with you this last weekend, too.
It sure was.
Thanks. All right.
How about Miss Angela Heikala?
Can you hear me?
We can.
Awesome. Hello. I'm Angela Heikla. I'm from Chisholm, Minnesota. And I started, well, actually, I was one of Liz's, I don't know if I was your first loyal customer, but one of pretty close, four and a half years ago. And I used the products. I switched back and forth as a loyal customer, trying to use a lot of the products and just kind of checking them out. And I did not join as a distributor until very end of January. It was like January 31st. And so I've only been in it for about 2.5 months. I reached executive just this last month, with the help of my team. I believe that teamwork and being connected with your team and plugging into these Zooms are very, very important. It keeps you going. It keeps you motivated. And it just, it has that drive for you. My why, my family and I just recently moved to the northern Minnesota, and we're struggling a little bit trying to get on our feet. So I thought, well, I got to find an opportunity that's going to help us out. And I called Liz up and I said, all right, now is my time. Because I always kept saying, not right now, Liz, not right now, and it was time. So, and I'm glad I did it, and I have amazing team members. And as a tip, I agree with all of you. I think all of these tips are wonderful. Some of the things that I've found that has worked is when I post on Facebook, I post about a product, and I keep the consistency of that product throughout the week. And it's so funny how the week goes on. Right at the end of the week, I'll finally have a few more people that are, okay, like, tell me about the greens or whatever. And it's like I've posted all week long, and then at the end of the week, then they'll message me. So I find that's helping. Blitzing is very scary for me. I agree with, I can't remember who it was that said about crying. Colleen, was that you? Yeah, that's exactly me. But once you do it, I think the more you do it is you get more used to it. I think that's it.
What do you like to say when you blitz? What do you? Because I know there's people that are brand new that are probably saying, well, what do you say when you hand out your little coupon card? What is something you like to say?
I usually say, have you ever heard of It Works? Or, I sometimes just strike up a conversation. It all depends on where I'm at or what I'm doing. Like my kids have, they're in martial arts or gymnastics. And sometimes I just have my stuff sitting there and I'm working on stuff and I can see their eyes constantly coming over to me. So I'm just like, so I'll start a conversation and then I'll kind of work into that and be like, have you ever heard of it? And I'll just kind of give them, it's a health and wellness and things like that. And I think people are very, like I just did a vendor show, my very first vendor show on Saturday. And a lot of people ask me, so do you use the products? So being a product of the product, I think, is very important. And when I say, yeah, actually, I've used the products for over 3 years, and I just started as a distributor because I wanted to feel what, the products myself before I actually sold something as well. So I got a lot of, wow, that's amazing. So it must really work if you're still using the products.
Yeah, I love that. That's a great, great, great tip. So yeah, I'm hearing again, consistency, following up, daily Facebook posting. I love how you use one product and just consistently post that throughout the entire week. So you say, greens, this is what it's going to be. Do you switch up the posts a little bit, or do you use the exact same one each day? Because everyone does not see.
Nope.
Go ahead.
Correct. I switch them up. So I do different things with them. So you may show, using the greens yourself or doing two different kinds of greens or explaining the greens, because like most of ours, everybody has a different color that you're, and sometimes the posts are really simple. Sometimes I get lengthy with them because everybody's going to react to them a little bit different.
It's true. When you're thinking of all the personality colors, you certainly are going to, reds are going to, want results, and green personality is going to want details. So that's true. When you think of blues, like fun. So when you're appealing to all those different colors, that's true. You should really be thinking about that. That's a great point. I love it. What's your goal by month then, Miss Angela?
Well, I'm right behind Becky here. So we might just be head and head. I think I'm liking her bling bling. I might have to come up with a different name for myself.
I love it. Well, thank you so much, Angela. Congratulations on your executive promotion in March. Yep. Good job.
Thank you.
All right. So how about Hillary Marr? Marr? Am I saying your last name right? Marr? Marr? Not for sure.
Marr.
Where are you, Hillary? There you are. Hey, girl. It was so fun to hang with you at the It Works U in Grand Rapids this past weekend.
A good weekend.
Yeah. So tell everybody who you are, where you're from, what you just recently promoted to, and then there's so many things. A little bit of your why, and then some business building tips.
All right, so I'm Hillary Maurer, and I'm from Baldwin, Wisconsin, and I have been using the product for about 2 years, and I joined about a year ago, and I kind of just found my why about a month or so ago at the One Team, One Mission in Mankato with Cammy. Someone else came up on the stage and kind of told her story, and it was like just the picture of me, like I saw myself right there in that. So it really hit me right there, and that's kind of what got me going. I hit executive last month. So I guess I just kind of, it was more mindset, I think, for me, just really messaging people and actually asking them to help me out, like be product testers and asking if they wanted to join, which I really kind of just posted before and not really asked people more. I kind of just let them come to me. So
that's a great tip. I love that, Hillary, because I think a lot of people think that. They think that if I post, then that should be good enough. And like John said before, that's really net wishing, not networking. So you have to ask yourself, the post itself would be like the advertisement, even though you're doing a really great job of being an attraction marketer, meaning you're posting things that are bringing people in, not looking like you're selling to them, because nobody wants to be sold to, right? You're telling stories, you're being creative with your posts and your products and showing how you're using them. You're posting about your family, friendships, food, you know, all those things with your business in there, you know, sprinkled in. But I love how you said that, because when you're doing that part, that's awesome. But your closing is actually when you're actually messaging people besides just the posting. So yeah, we can just post, but then we're probably going to wait for 10 years before we go to the next level. If we hope, you know what I mean? That we hope that somebody will message us. And you do get that occasional, you know, message that somebody says, oh, tell me more about this. But you're absolutely right. You made a really, really great point there. Okay, so then let's see. So your big flip of your switch was attending an event, right? You went to a One Team, One Mission. And for those of you that are, you know, on this Zoom, maybe none of you have, or maybe you don't know that there's an actual website. When you go to myitworksevents.com, you can see if there's a local One Team, One Mission event or an It Works University training coming to your area. So you should definitely check out that calendar and get to one, because like Hillary said, she's been with us for, is it, you said a couple years now?
No, it was a year in February.
Okay, a year. And it was just this last month, after attending a One Team, One Mission, that she heard someone else up on the stage who was in her same predicament. And she said, oh, now that I need to, if she can do it, I can do it. And that is exactly what happened to me when I went to Florida and I heard people that were on WIC and government aid and living paycheck to paycheck, and now we're full-time mom and dad at home. And I said, that's me. And why am I not doing that? So I absolutely, you know, would totally encourage people to definitely get to an event besides, you know, the fact that you're on this, which is a huge step in being here and being plugged in. All right. So any other tips you'd share, Hillary?
Just being consistent, because I've, like I said, I kind of just posted here and there, and now I've been posting. I mean, I post on Facebook at least 5-6 times with, you know, other things in between to keep people looking. And just keep messaging, because even if it's not their time now, their time could be next month or in 2 months. You know, that's how I got my first distributor. She had been watching for almost the whole year. And I just, now when I started getting more consistent, I think is kind of, she was ready then too. And yep, just asking and being consistent.
I love that.
Yeah, you know, I just want to say this too, Hillary. You know, one of the things that I notice about you is that the light in your eyes seems different when we're together and you talk about the business. And another big difference I see is that it looks like you're having fun. I mean, you know, you're just grinning from ear to ear when we're together this last weekend. And, you know, would you say to everybody that you're just a lot more relaxed and having a lot more fun since you kind of got your why in front of you and, you know, you're working for that reason?
Yeah. And just the friendships being made too with the different groups going on with promoting. Has been really, really great getting to know more people, and actually getting to meet them this weekend was awesome. So it was a lot of fun.
That's awesome.
That's so cool. So yeah, those of you that are on this page and you don't know about the destination diamond, or excuse me, the destination groups there are, make sure you ask the person who you joined with so that you can find out which group you can be in, because there's groups for every single level that's helping you to know what to do at that level to get to the next level. So that's really a cool thing as well. So thank you so much, Hillary. We're super, super excited for you. All right, so then we have one last one for tonight, and we have more that will happen next month because we have so many. You guys can see this is so many awesome promotions. There were 24 promotions on our team in March, and I'm fully expecting at least that, if not double, for this next month. I'm looking at you all. Show me your eyeballs. I'm looking in your eyes. I'm seeing it. You're all going to the next level, if not double promoting. Put your hand up and say aye. Even though I can't hear you. Aye. So if you're a distributor, you're going executive. What's that look like? Well, ask your upline who brought you in. What does that look like? And if your upline isn't alive anymore or decided to fly a kite, then ask me or ask us, whatever that looks like. We'll get that next chart printed out for you, show you where that's at, and get you started. So if you're diamond, you're going executive. If you're executive, you're going ruby. If you're ruby, you're going emerald. Emerald going diamond. Diamond going double. Double going triple, and so on and so forth. Okay, Miss Chris Tollefson, my back van buddy. We rode in a van together, and we were scrunched in the back like sardines, but it was very fun. We got to know each other really well.
Yep, they logged like, what, 1,500 miles of closeness.
Yes, to our It Works You. Where are you, Miss Chris?
She had to leave. She had to work at 9:30, so she had to hop off, but she
Kayla, you speak on her behalf, Kayla Lund.
Okay, she said that this was all possible through her team, her promotion, and she's very grateful for that. Teamwork makes the dream work. And, I hate that when you're not an iPhone, your iPhone texting a Galaxy or something, it all mixes up. So I got to, like, unscramble these text messages. She's saying that It Works Family has made her a better person, and that going to an event this weekend hit something inside of her that she never felt that she would feel. And she didn't expect to want to cry, but she nearly almost did. What else?
Aww.
Yeah, and we've just made her a better person. And she can't wait to go to the next step. So that's what she said.
Awesome.
Thank you.
All right, and we're gonna do a quick shout out to Kayla's guy that she helped bring
Patrick.
On into the Patrick.
Where's
Patrick? Because Patrick is on, and you know, we definitely have to shout out guys because, hey, let's face it.
Boom.
You know, in a lot of ways, It Works has not tapped into the other 50% of the market that's out there.
Not
and
enough.
So, you know, the guys that are getting onto this business are really pioneers in this business in so many ways because they're making it cool for other guys to try products and get on into the business and try it out. So, Patrick, you've positioned yourself in a very, very important spot. Do you want to unmute yourself and just say hi to everybody?
Thank you, Kayla, by the way, for talking on behalf of Chris. We love her. Congratulations, Chris. All right, Patrick.
Well, hi, everybody. I'm Patrick, or as Kayla would know, PJ. I don't always go by Patrick, but
PJ it is then.
Yep. Kayla's been after me for a while. She's pretty subtle about it, but she does a good job of nudging me every once in a while. She did a good job, obviously, at nudging me to be part of the team. So excited to keep going. I just got my third loyal yesterday, and I almost had a fourth. I've got like four or five more that I think I'll have tomorrow, hopefully.
Awesome.
I'm always telling Kayla, I'm like, oh, I had one, but I'll get it tomorrow. So
that's awesome. Tell everybody what you do, Patrick. Sorry. What do you do for a living?
I worked in manufacturing for about 11 years. I worked as an assembler. So I started at the very bottom of a manufacturing company and worked in just about every department. And at last October, I was a plant manager for a manufacturing facility here in Willmar, Minnesota. and I was laid off. I was putting a plan together to lay off a bunch of people, and the day came to do that dirty part of the job, and I was the first to go. So
no.
Yeah. I've been on both sides of it. I've had to do a lot of that, and unfortunately this time I was the first to go. Not the end of the world. I kind of looked at it as an opportunity to find something better. I didn't want to stick with manufacturing. Mm-hmm. And for the last 4, 5, 6 months almost, I've just kind of done whatever. I was in a position to be able to find something different. So this is what I'm putzing with at the moment, but I'm not putzing with it by any means at all. I'm trying to go for it. So
yeah.
I was going to say, after hearing all these people that have promoted, I bet you're going, oh man, no more sitting around, right? Let's get on the ball and earn some of these bonuses, right?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
We got to get you connected with some of these other men who do it solely with It Works. We got to get you connected with some of these, because it's incredible. Some of these people that are ambassadors, yeah, like Kyler Pentecost, you know, top of the company and doing it all solely as a man with no spouse or significant other. And so there's definitely men doing it in this business, which is very cool. And something Sarah Zard on our Zoom here somewhere, she did a vendor event with John once, and she said there is definitely something very awesome about doing a vendor show, you know, having your table at a different vendor show. It's amazing how when you have a man's presence there, more men come up to the table. And typically you see the women behind the table. And I notice that when John and I do events together too, that a lot more people will go, man, you guys do this together. This is like your full-time thing. And it just brings those men to feel like, all right, well, if he's there, then I should come up to the table. Like John said, we definitely don't, as women, we tend to go more towards the women than we do the men. So I love that Kayla approached you, PJ, and said, you know what? I think you could do this. And aren't you a personal trainer or do something with health and fitness or whatever?
I have always been an avid gym member. I've had a Snap Fitness membership for almost 10 years now. I'm a part of a bunch of different fitness groups in the Wilmer area. I've got a group that goes out to the local college with me on the weekends, and there's a big hill, and we do all sorts of different exercises with the hill and the football field and tires, and just to get out and be active. And this is just one more tool to be better at that. So hopefully they'll all jump on board.
Awesome.
That's awesome. So don't forget to, you know, pop your greens in around those people, or, you know, whatever energy it is, just, you know, basically live your It Works life, you know, in the wide open in front of them. And it shouldn't be, they should be asking you, you know?
Yep.
So awesome to meet you.
Yes. So
Patrick is coming with to Jackpot, I think, right? Maybe Friday. So we have a vendor event that we're going to do, and he's going to come. So we can report back how that went then with the guy next
week. Awesome.
So. That's awesome. That's
congratulations,
great.
Guys.
Yeah. Cool. I think that was everyone that we were going to interview. Like I said, I have a listing of people for next time too, because we just have so many, and I know we're going to be shouting out even more, because every single one of you, let me look at you, are going to be promoting. Let me look to the next level. I'm looking. Kiki. I'm seeing Kiki. Tessie, calling y'all out. Leah Grachek, boom, boom. Sarah Zart, Michelle, Megan with her cute little baby. I love it.
Jenny's got her hands up.
That's right. I'm just looking all you all over. Let me just see here. Boom, boom. Samantha.
Elizabeth had two hands up.
There you go. Yes, Liz French. My back, again, the back of the van, buddy. Awesome. Okay, so let's just share a few things from the It Works University. How about Liz French? Because you were one that was attending. Can you unmute yourself and share something from this past weekend that you really took away from the It Works University? It was a training, one-day training, and they do these all over the place. The next one, I think, is in St. Louis. Am I saying this right? June, Kayla?
It's June 4th, so it'd be like the 3rd to the 5th if somebody was going out there.
So people are road tripping to St. Louis, Missouri to go to that one. I know there's a few already on hand that have been talking about that.
So. All right, so Liz French.
Where are you, Miss Liz?
Hey, guys. This weekend was so awesome. Just, it was my first event too. And just to get to meet my people that are family now, and just, it was just incredible. And I think something you said, John, or was it Liz? One of you said, giving up the good to go for the great, and just sacrificing a little bit now, make it so much better later. My family's really, we're pumped. We're working it.
Awesome. So you came back and you said, we talked about in the car, let's put a game plan together with your family and really get serious about this business, and don't let this season pass you by. That it's time to step up and say, all right, we're putting our game face on. We're going for this. You know, and a lot of times when you talk about your family, like I know for us, husband and wife, kids, we have to talk about what that looks like. Like, what is that going to look like as we go for these bonuses? And, you know, John and I, it's like, all right, well, you're going to have to pick up the slack with the kids at home while I'm going out, or I'm on my computer for extra, or I'm on my phone for longer, or I'm Zooming with extra people in the month, or whatever that looks like to make that happen, because we know that we're giving up the good to go for what's even way more awesome. And for us, that was bringing him home from his construction business and being that full-time family. So were you guys able to put a little game plan together?
Yeah, we are. I mean, I don't know if you guys saw my picture on Facebook. Timmy was helping with the dishes.
I saw that. He had his game hat on, too.
He does. James is helping with the laundry. I mean, everyone's just helping out. We were talking about, okay, what are our goals for family goals when we reach Ruby, when we reach Emerald, Diamond? What, you know, what are we going to do as a family for those?
You know, I love that, Liz, because I remember when we sat down with our three kids and we were getting serious about some promotions, and we asked the kids, what did they have in mind for goals? And, you know, they listed off some stuff like maybe like a new Xbox. And you know, I know Disney was on there too. And you know what? I'm pretty sure that's going to happen this summer. So, you know, that when they can put their goals on a goal sheet, you'd be surprised how having that in front of them makes them so much easier to work with during the day. I mean, we all know how kids can be a little bit, you know, they have a mind of their own, and that's okay, but it's amazing how people can pull together in the same direction when you get your goals lined up.
Yeah. And so with that, with John saying, do you guys all know, I got to look here. Thank you, Liz, for sharing, sweetheart. I'm going to look across here. Did you guys see that there's green carpet? They announced green carpet July 11th through 16th. John and I got our tickets while we were there, because do you know that it sold out in less than 24 hours? That is crazy. Like that, we just know when they announce something, it just every single time lately, the pattern has been 24 hours. It's gone. So we didn't even have a chance to think or even talk. We just said, we're going to get our tickets so that we make sure that we get them. So this is a family week. So it works that this green carpet is only one day while you're down there. It's either Friday the 15th, I believe, or Saturday the 16th. And the days from the 11th up to that point, they announced at this It Works University that they're actually like kind of, what do you want to call it, renting out the town of Palmetto, Florida. So they're actually having all these events for your family planned each day, that if you want to sign up for them, that you can do them. He announced water activities, you know, whether it's jet skiing or whatever, boat riding or parasailing. It was just things every week that you could do if you wanted with your families, and then attend the training, which would be either all day Friday or all day Saturday. So I know Steph Grodczyk and her team is coming, going down there. I know they've already rented a resort, and I think there was four left at their resort, and they only had like suites left. So I'm telling you, the It Works people are already taking over.
She's saying they're gone now.
Stephanie, they're gone? Oh my goodness, they're gone already. So it's
but there's other stuff available too. Like, we were looking online today too, and there's reasonably priced stuff out on the beach. And so, you know, if you guys are interested in that, what Mark has done is he's opened up the availability to buy a webcast while you're down there. So
live streaming.
A live stream. So that means that you can watch the live stream of the event, whether it's, you know, Friday, Saturday, whatever. And then you can take the whole rest of the week to join in
with with the team,
with the rest of us, because that's what we're going to be doing. So, you know, what you're missing inside is not going to be all that much. So if you want to come down and have the experience, we would highly recommend that. And, you know, we would for sure all get together and make it a great time.
Yeah, so definitely if you're thinking, you know, let's go check it out and hang with people and do the fun activities and kind of figure out and get to know the It Works culture, it's really awesome. And they're going to have, like you said, the downtown is all aware that we're coming. They're going to be flying It Works flags all over Palmetto, Florida, down the streets.
There's going to be discounts.
There's going to be discounts at like most restaurants and everything for It Works people. So there's going to be a lot of black, green, and bling all over Palmetto, Florida. And we're bringing our family down. We're making total memories of it and doing Disney one day, because that's something that's been on our dream board for 3.5 years. And so we really encourage you. And if you can't for whatever reason, then buy the live streaming, the pay-per-view, which is, I posted it in Team Enter. It's also when you log into your website and get together with your team, like get together with your clusters of team and go ahead. And I saw Stacey Durings doing a potluck with her team. They're just going to all come over and party together and watch the live stream. Am I right? Potluck? Potlucks are the best.
It's going to be what?
We're kind of doing whoever around the area to all get together I believe on that Saturday. And so it's opened up to anyone around the area or who wants to drive down though too. But I think it's good for those that aren't able to make the trip to Florida to all be plugged in together. It's kind of a fun thing to do as a team and get to know each other. And I think our plan is that we're possibly doing it at Lisa Tolbert's house. So we're all gonna just hang out together and have a good time. So
awesome.
Anyone is invited. So reach out to myself or Lisa.
Eagle Lake.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, and then the other thing that we kind of learned, you know, we got a game plan. CEO Mark, we went to the Triple Diamond and Above VIP leadership evening where we got to hear our CEO Mark Pentecost talk, and he gave us each an offensive. The wrong, what do you say?
Wrong emphasis on the wrong
syllabus. But anyways. So this game plan book, and it's really, really awesome. And we're planning, we still haven't had a chance to like scan everything because we've been looking at places to rent today too, as well as reaching out to people, but it really gives you a plan for being very intentional in your business. So I want to scan these and put these up in the files on Team Enter so that you guys can see. I loved the first thing that said, step one is how much was your last paycheck? So you just have to write how much it was. And take your 40 hours per week by 4 weeks, which is 160 hours. So that's based on a typical 40-hour week. So take that your last paycheck, divide it by 160, and that will tell you how much you make an hour with It Works Global. I thought that was a really cool way to really see how much you're making with It Works. Do you want to make more than that, or do you want, you know what I mean? So, and like for us, we want triple that, you know what I mean? Triple what we're seeing there. So that's really awesome. And then he talked about keeping your business a third, a third, a third. So when you work your business, you should spend a third of your time on building your business. If you don't have any team members on your team, that means what you're doing is you're focusing on your steps to success. And we're all doing that as leaders, no matter what, if we have a team member or we don't. We're all putting these out every single month, gathering 4 loyal customers. Our goal is to grab at least 3 distributors, if not more, so that we can hit our Ruby and just keep recycling that and help build rubies into our organization. Because we know building rubies, oh my goodness, did you know 54 rubies gets you to the top of the organization? That builds an ambassador. Ambassador makes $585,000 a year. So if you can build 54 rubies are just 5 people on these clusters of teams, then you can be an ambassador diamond. So don't miss that doing your Ruby and then being able to turn around and teach that Ruby to people, right? So don't get off course with that. You know, Joel Dunn said he's a black diamond, makes over $100,000 per month. He's a millionaire, and he was on stage this last weekend. And he said, You know, it takes, everyone makes everything complicated. It takes a genius to simplify, okay? We get way off track being distracted by looking at everybody else's plate, looking at what everybody else is doing, saying, what's wrong with me? Why isn't it going as fast as I am? When we should be concentrating on bringing in loyal customers and bringing in distributors. Again, how many are you chatting with each day, right? Because we know as we plant seeds, we'll always be having more and more happening. Now, then that goes back to, all right, well, where's your hundreds list? Where is that? Do you have that filled out and printed off with your 100 names? You know, getting started with that. And if you don't even know where to start there, well, print off the memory jogger that's in your document library section that helps you think of 100 names so you know where to even begin. You know what I love to do? I love to take my product catalog or go online if you don't have your business builder kit, because certainly don't wait for a business builder kit to come to start asking for product testers and building your team. But open up the product catalog and start writing names down by them that you can think of that you'd like to ask people to be a product tester for you and get it at 40% off. I like to say, what I can offer you, I'm looking for product testers. You know, would you like to try greens or, you know, a couple products? And then I said, what I can offer you is 40% off. I can offer you 10% back from every order. I can offer you 10 immediate free perk points, which is like $3. And then the last one you could say is, I can offer you free shipping at month 4 and on. I mean, that's basically the loyal customer program. That's a few of the things on the loyal customer program. So that's, you always want to remind yourself that you're asking how you can help other people. It's not about what they can do for you. It's what can you do for them? And this is what I can offer to you. Same thing with the distributorship, same kind of idea. You know, there's a $500 bonus on the table right now with our company. I'd like to know if I can help you earn that. Could you use an extra $500? And this is what I know I can offer you. I can offer you one-on-one coaching, because you're going to coach them. I can offer you support. I can offer you some awesome Facebook groups, because we have the tribe and we have It Works Team Mentor with a plethora of information. And what else? You can offer them, you know, helping them go and get their $500 bonus. Now, you're not guaranteeing they're going to get that if they're not going to move and start working. But those are things that we can offer people. And if you need help with script ideas, what to say, we've got a script thread. It says scripts to send out. There's a ton of scripts in there. There's also, if you look on the top of It Works Team Enter, there's a file that's called scripts. There's also a file called word choices. The same on Tribe. There's Walmer scripts. There's a script document just called scripts. So there's many different scripts out there. At the end of the day, it comes down to action. It really does come down to action, because we can all talk all day long about what we want and how this or that. But at the end of the day, we have to ask ourselves, evaluate ourselves. So how did we do today? Did we reach out to the 10 or the 20 that we said we were going to do? I've talked a lot. Does anybody want to say anything? So on this game plan, it also talks about blitzing, wrapping, repeating, keeping it simple. Blitzing, wrapping, repeating.
And we will make copies of that, and we're going to get that out to you guys so that you have it. And so, in the light of keeping things short here, yeah, that's funny because we're almost an hour and a half in already. But
this has been so good, though.
Thank you so much, everyone, so for good. Joining us. And, you know, if any of you have anything that we can do for you to help you build your business quicker, let us know. We're here for you, and we want you guys to succeed. So, this was an awesome Zoom.
It was. You guys are fabulous. The tips that were shared, oh my goodness. Can't say enough about consistency, because I love when people say things don't happen some days. You know, your goals happen when you do things every day, the small, consistent things. So you guys can do this. I mean, it's all here up in the mindset. You can do this. You heard many people of many walks of life here, just on our team alone, sharing what they did and how they did it. But it was a lot of boom, mindset and action.
Definitely. So, word of encouragement on that is find a piece of personal development book or something, or video, you know, audio, free audio from YouTube. And trust me, 10 pages a day to start, or even what does that translate to? 15 minutes, half an hour of YouTube. And if you want a suggestion, please ask us, because I've got a ton of stuff that, I could get you going on. But if you don't personal develop, honestly, your business can't grow beyond where your mindset is right now, where your personal lid is. So Liz and I have done a ton of mindset training, and we're just, I can't tell you what to do, but I'm telling you to go do some mindset. It's huge. It's absolutely huge. So
did you say John Maxwell?
I didn't say anything.
Yeah, John Maxwell's a great place to start. So let's close this in prayer, if you guys don't mind, because, you know, we really need the Lord's blessing in this. You know, we ask for him to really, help us move forward and be able to open the floodgates. So if you don't mind, we'll just close this in prayer, and then we'll end this, and then we'll get the recording up maybe tonight or tomorrow, and you guys can send this out to people and watch it again if you'd like. All right, so here we go. Dear Heavenly Father, we are just so very blessed and so very thankful for all that you've given. You know, everything that we have around us, for simple things like food in our refrigerator, roofs over our head, air in our lungs, children, our spouse, our jobs, this It Works business, these people here, Lord, we are so very thankful. We ask that you would just truly just help us here with our businesses. Help bring people in our path that absolutely need these products. And let these products transform lives, Lord. We ask that you would just transform people's lives as their with their health goals and with their wellness goals. We also ask that you would put people in front of us that need this business, need it, and need it like they need air. That they would understand the vision that's here, the gift that's here, the blessing that we have to offer, and that they would jump in without any fear. And Lord, I would also ask that you would help these people on this call tonight and those that are watching to not have any fear as well. Give them the confidence that they need that this is a blessing. This is a gift. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to change our life. Lord, use us as your instruments. Let us, you know, do your work here and show others your glory. We ask all of this in your name. Amen. Love you guys. Thank you for all the fun. I just want to stand here and look at everybody. Hehehe